Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for this segment. Today we are joined by Acting Prosecutor Chris Gramiccioni. Welcome, Prosecutor. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you. Very nice to be here.
Always a pleasure to have you here on Monmouth in Focus. And we have lots to talk about.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's start with CrimeStoppers that was recently unveiled and another effort to fight crime.
Just one of many efforts to fight crime. Law enforcement across the county, and across the country for that matter, we often suffer from a lack of information, a lack of intelligence about crimes that are committed. Witnesses don't talk to us. There's a stop snitching movement that's afoot across the country. We feel like Crime Stoppers, the basic premise behind it, is to give financial incentive for anonymous information. And we feel like that's going to help among all the other opportunities we have to go out there and fight crime. We think that's going to give some incentive for people to talk to us.
So why Crime Stoppers? Why not just rely on the people for the information? Or sometimes they're too afraid to come forward, even though no questions asked? Or
that's exactly right. In some communities, there's a distrust of law enforcement. And people are afraid. People are afraid of retaliation, or maybe they have allegiances that they don't want people to know about. But Crime Stoppers is a separate charity that's unaffiliated with the prosecutor's office or municipal police. Those people that decide they want to communicate with them, they can give tips to them completely anonymously, separate and apart from any law enforcement entity, and provide it for cash, no questions asked, and doesn't necessarily mean they're going to end up being witnesses or anything because we don't know who they are. It's just intelligence and information is all it boils down to.
Along with that, though, could come people that are just trying to make some money off of this, obviously. So how do you weed that out?
Well, it's driven by this. They give a tip. Mm-hmm. They give an anonymous tip. That tip is passed on to an investigating agency, let's say my office, the Monmouth County Prosecutors. Mm-hmm. If that tip was fruitful and it results in us making an arrest or a prosecution, then we communicate with Crime Stoppers and we let them know that the tip was fruitful, it worked out, and then Crime Stoppers gives them a reward. It's usually 99 times out of 100 is driven on whether we make an arrest or a prosecution. In some cases, it's if we find a stash of narcotics or weapons or things like that.
Right. Now, can the person remain anonymous the whole time, and then how would they get that reward if it were to get to that point?
That's a good question. They remain anonymous the entire time. Mm-hmm. Crime Stoppers, all they maintain is a phone number with no name. That person that gives the tip is given a PIN code, and if their tip is fruitful, if it works out, then they can take that PIN code and go to a bank that's affiliated with the Crime Stoppers program, and they're given the cash reward that's set ahead of time by the Crime Stoppers charity with no questions asked.
That sounds like a great effort there.
I hope so. I've seen it work across the country mm-hmm. in different urban centers. We hope that it'll help our efforts here.
Right. You know, and it's so true. The people who live in the communities are the eyes and ears of what's going on there. You know, I mean, how important is that through, whether it be a text to tip or an anonymous line, Crime Stoppers, it's really getting people involved and law enforcement and those people trusting each other and working together.
It's the most important thing that we have, people who care about their communities and have a civic responsibility and want to fight crime. Whether they do it anonymously or whether they come to a police department and make a witness statement, we need that information. There's no substitute for it. Cameras, other surveillance techniques, other investigative uses that we employ, nothing substitutes real-time personal information.
Also, you know, Prosecutor, it's important to note that the Prosecutor's Office supports this, the Sheriff's Office supports this, but those agencies do not run Crime Stoppers. Who runs it?
Absolutely. It's a 501c3 charity that's run by people made up different people in the community, past and present business members, past and present law enforcement, some public officials, elected officials are on our board. For example, our past prosecutor, John Kay, mm-hmm. Assemblyman Dave Reibel. It's those types of people that run it. We have no role in it. They're a partner in law enforcement, but they don't work for me. They don't work for the sheriffs or the county of Monmouth. Mm-hmm. They're a completely independent and separate charity.
So in a sense, that charity is processing all of the tips. They're processing, if they are valid tips. They alert you when they say, hey, this looks like this could be a pretty good lead, and then the prosecutor's office obviously is in charge of the investigation, and that's how they utilize the anonymous tips.
Yes, ma'am, that's right. In fact, it's the National Crime Stoppers program. They have a call center in Texas that routes all of the information, the tips that are received. It's mm-hmm. routed through them and then routed back to us. And if when those tips work out, they're the ones that let us know whether we can let Crime Stoppers know when they can release the reward money. The reward money is published ahead of time.
How important is this in the fight against crime?
I think it's vital because, like I said, it's unfortunate right now we're in a scenario, especially in certain urban centers across the county and across the state for that matter. We're not getting information on crimes that are unsolved and at this point in time cold. We need that information. For example, violent crimes, we're going to focus heavy on that. When we petition Crime Stoppers, we're going to be trying to solve unsolved murders, things like that. Mm-hmm. And it's vital because those cases have run cold in large part. We need something to point that investigative barometer into the right direction.
Some great points there. Thanks so much for joining us, Acting Prosecutor Christopher Gramiccioni.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here.
For more information, you can go to www.visitmonmouth.com. I'm Cynthia Scott. Have a great day, everyone.